it's no secret that people love a hot spring. They inevitably turn into vacation destinations for tourists and people looking for healing wherever they are, from Japan to Iceland. And of course, the Roman baths reign supreme as historically beloved hot springs. But humans are not the only ones that love hot water. The Roman baths are also chock full of heat-loving organisms called thermophiles. And those little bathing buddies have some nifty adaptations that help them thrive in the extreme heat. And as we have recently discovered, those adaptations can help people and the planet thrive, too. Straight out of the Department of Redundancy Department, the Roman baths were built, wait for it, by the Romans in Bath, a town that is now called Bath in England. The baths we know were built around 70 AD, and they take advantage of three natural hot springs in the area that are kind of a geological anomaly. There are six areas with geothermal springs in the British Isles, but only the ones at Bath are actual hot springs. The water in Bath reaches more than 45 degrees Celsius, while the other springs are all well below 30 degrees. The first geological mapping of this area was done by William Smith in the late 1700s, and thanks to his maps of the rock layers in and around Bath, he is credited with inventing the whole concept of stratigraphy. And even though people have been studying what's going on here since the late 1700s, we still don't exactly know why these hot springs formed where they did. There's a pretty strong consensus that the water itself comes from precipitation thousands of years ago, buried at least 2,500 meters down. But that doesn't explain why these particular springs are so much hotter than the rest of the other springs in Britain. One idea is that the water emerges from the Earth along a geological feature called a thrust fault, where older rocks get pushed above younger rocks, or that the hot springs are located on one of the fault lines that cross the area. A more recent hypothesis is that the formation of the Avon Valley in the Pleistocene led to a buildup of fine-grained sediment, which put pressure on the limestone underneath, which collapsed in on itself to form rock tunnels that bring heated water from deep under the earth to the surface. But like I said, no one's sure. It's a fun little mystery. However they came to be there, people have been taking advantage of them for healing and wellness for millennia. A medieval legend claims that the baths were originally discovered in the 9th century BCE by a Celtic prince who cured his leprosy by submerging in the waters. That's not true. That didn't happen. He also learned to fly and fathered King Lear, though it's unclear whether those events are in any way related to the hot springs. In the 1700s, people flocked to this area with complaints ranging from skin problems to sterility to sciatica. So many people came that they had to establish the Royal Mineral Water Hospital, the first public hospital in Britain. There's always been an interest in identifying the secret sauce that makes the water so restorative. And in 1903, people thought they had found an answer in one of the big health crises of the time. Radiation. Yeah, they found a bunch of radium salts in the water, which they determined to be the secret to the water's healing powers. And so, a radium inhalatorium was built so people could come and breathe the radioactive air, you know, for their health. The site is now home to a spa next door where people come for healing and relaxation, presumably without the radium. Some of this healing is most likely mythical, but the springs may actually be a source of medical treatments after all, thanks to something else in the water. Uranium. No, I'm kidding. It's bacteria.
Thanks to Jump for supporting this SciShow video. Jump is a statistical analysis software that makes powerful analytics quick and accessible. I know at SciShow we talk a lot about the data that scientists collect from experiments in the lab, but lots of people use data in their jobs, like policy analysts. And if that's you, Jump has modeling tools that can up your game with both quantitative and qualitative data. Jump can even analyze survey data. You can find segmentation, choice models, and max diff all in one place. And if you really want to level up, Jump Pro has an entire platform devoted to exploring text. Instead of manually reading through pages and pages of open-ended survey responses, Jump offers a way to mine loads of unstructured text with just the click of a button. Qualitative or sentiment analysis just got a whole lot less subjective and a whole lot faster. You can get going today at jump.com/scishow, and you'll even get a 30-day free trial.
We're specifically talking about a subcategory of bacteria called thermophiles. Thermophiles are organisms that are adapted to live in extremely hot places the rest of us would never be able to, like, say, hot springs. And they are incredibly diverse. They have to be to develop the ability to stand the heat. And all that biodiversity means there's also a lot of diversity in other characteristics, too. It turns out that thermophiles produce a lot of different compounds with all sorts of useful properties. Antibacterial, anti-cancer, antifungal, antiviral, you get it. In 2024, scientists discovered 297 different species of archaea and bacteria in the water of the Roman baths and one of the springs that feed the complex. And this isn't like the grossness that comes from millions of people sitting around and making human soup. These are tough little microbes that are super well adapted to the specific, funky ecosystem that is a centuries-old bathhouse. And these particular thermophiles aren't just protected from heat. 15 of the species researchers discovered could make their own pathogen-fighting compounds. Some of the bacteria were actinobacteria, which are a source of a bunch of current antibiotics like vancomycin and erythromycin. And the bacteria myxococcata produce a whole bunch of potentially beneficial compounds, and both were found in the water. The researchers also put these organisms to the test by pitting them against the bacteria that cause staph infections and a couple that cause diarrhea. And they did pretty well at fighting them off. So that's promising for the future treatment of diseases that we really struggle with. It's early stages and it'll take a lot more research, but the hope is that someday they'll help us develop new medications to treat antibiotic-resistant bacteria, which currently kill more than a million people a year. But scientists are thinking bigger than just healing people. They are also studying the potential of the microbes in the baths to heal the world. That might be a bit of an exaggeration, but the biodiversity in the bath hot springs also gives rise to microalgae that are promising as potential biofuels. In general, microalgae are being studied for use as biofuels because they reproduce quickly, so you can make a lot of them really fast. But most of them are also really sensitive to temperature fluctuations, and getting them even a little bit too hot can kill your whole colony. But that is not true for the ones we find in the Roman baths, where the algae have just the right nutrient profiles to make them great energy sources. And growing them at super high temperatures actually protects against the supply being contaminated by normie bacteria, because they just can't handle that heat. All of this means that the baths that have been around for millennia could have an important role to play in the future, too. So everyone from the Celts to the Romans and then the Victorians, maybe were actually onto something when they thought that the water could cure all that ailed them. It just wasn't the radium. Please don't inhale radium.